Let's jump right into verifying your domain, which you have to do with iOS 14. After you verify your domain, for things to track properly, you'll have to set up link aggregated events, which I cover in the video, in the description, and in the pinned comment. You'll start by going to business.facebook.com and make sure you have the right business manager. If you're just regularly on Facebook, you can go to ads or business manager to get to the same point. So we're gonna click the little gear in the corner. Now you will have to have set it up with Business Manager. So if you haven't, I'll have a card pop up on how to do that. We're gonna go down to Brand Safety and then Domains. So then you'll have the option to add a domain. You don't need www. Or anything like that. I actually purchased this domain just for this tutorial. So we'll click Add. Whenever possible, you want your own domain, so jacoble.com rather than jacoble.myshopify.com. This builds trust with customers, but Facebook also likes it significantly more. Now you're given a couple of options. Now I definitely prefer updating the DNS TXT on every platform, but especially on Shopify. I know it sounds complex, but I'll explain it in a second, but I am going to provide exact instructions for using it in the Metatag. With Metatag, you're adding code to your site, and on Shopify, you're adding that code to your theme, which could create issues when you switch themes later on. To do DNS, there's three steps you need to take. You need to log in to whoever you bought your domain with, find DNS records, and then paste whatever we copy from this clipboard. So let me copy this to the clipboard. I'm gonna save it just in text edit to make it easier to access later. And for Shopify, if I bought it through Shopify, I can just go to online store, then to domains. And since I bought this one through Shopify, I can simply click on it and here's DNS settings. And when we're under there, we're gonna add a TXT record. Just leave this at. And then I'm gonna paste what I just copied and click confirm. And that's all set. You may be using a separate service like GoDaddy or Namecheap. In this example, I have this domain for Namecheap. I can just go to manage. And right away I see DNS. And I'm looking to add a record, so I can click add new record. Again, go to TXT. For if it says host, just do at. We'd paste whatever we copied. And if it says TTL, you can just leave that as it is. Final example is WPX. If you go under manage service, right there you'll see edit DNS. That's what we're looking for. We can choose our domain and then add a new record. Make sure it's a TXT. Again, do at, paste, and just leave this blank. Be sure you save the record as well. Going back to Facebook, if you were able to follow along, it can take up to 72 hours for it to recognize it. I have found sometimes it takes 24. You can try verifying the domain. Okay, that happened pretty quick for me. The moment you finish verifying your domain, you'll want to go to the video linked in the comments in the description where I cover setting up link aggregated events. This is the only way you can track things properly. If you don't set it up correctly, you could have 100 purchases come in and have it show 0 purchases. Did you know liking the video helps it reach other people? So if this was helpful to you, I'd really love for you to give it a little tap. If you weren't able to do it in my preferred method of DNS, I want to show you how to do it as a Metatag on Shopify and WordPress. Let me start with Shopify. We're going to copy this bit of text. Then we're going to go to our clipboard. I'm just going to paste that so I can access it later. Now on Shopify, we'll go to online store. And then under the theme, we're actually going to add it to the theme. So you'll want to think about this if you switch themes, make sure it's still in the code of the new one. Go to edit code. And then you'll go to theme.liquid. So now we need to paste this just somewhere in the head section. I'll usually do right before the end. Put it at the start. Make sure you save it. Now you can go back to Business Manager and make sure you verify the domain. The moment you finish verifying your domain, you'll want to go to the video linked in the comments in the description where I cover setting up link aggregated events. This is the only way you can track things properly. If you don't set it up correctly, you could have 100 purchases come in and have it show 0 purchases. Did you know liking the video helps it reach other people? So if this was helpful to you, I'd really love for you to give it a little tap. For WordPress, I still recommend DNS, but if that's not working or confusing, you can go to add a meta tag and then just copy this meta tag to your clipboard. I'm gonna save it here as well to make it easier to access later. Then I'm gonna go into the WordPress dashboard and go to plugins, go to add new. And the one I like is called head, footer, and post injections. If you just do head, footer, it should come up. Head, footer, and post injections. You can do install now and then activate. I already have it on mine. And once it's installed, if you go to settings and then header and footer, now you can add this to your head section. Now you can actually see it says just to put it on the home page, not every single page of the website. So we're actually going to go to only on the home page, and you can just paste it right in there and make sure you save it. It can take up to 72 hours for it to take effect. Let's see if it worked. Okay, it did verify it pretty quickly. You're not done yet, because by default, the events will not track properly, which will wreck your entire results. So you have to watch the video up there. Did you know liking the video helps it reach other people? So if this was helpful to you, I'd really love for you to give it a little tap.